Hello, welcome back to my channel, Queen Judah Economics 101. And today I'm going to talk about investing in your home and reviewing the grass that exists in your home so that you can plant the type of grass that you would like. I only recommend this for people who are homeowners. If you want to do it while you're renting, that's fine. I just feel that you're putting work and investment in other people's property that you never own. So, but if you can do that, you can. However, the type of work I'm going to invest in would be for my own home. And it's right now, I'm looking at my grass that is existing. And I'm thinking about planting the type of grass that I want. As you can see, this grass is very weedy. So the first thing you want to do is let the grass grow as high as it can so that you can see what type of grass is existing. And as you can see, I'm going to zero in. This grass is very weedy. Here's some weeds right here. These are the grass seeds. You want to let it grow high to see what you got. I don't believe in cutting my grass and let the grass grow back in. I have a bag and I pick it up. I just don't want the grass to go back in to smother it. You want to see your dirt. And when you plant that grass back in there, you go down in there. But if you're using a lawnmower without a bag, the grass is going to go right back in there and just smother the grass, where the ground where it can't grow. I like to see my ground, see? So I would use a bag or my lawnmower to throw my grass off and not put it back in. Some people like, it's called thashing or mulching. I would mulch it and put it in the bag and take it out. And I'll show you why. That's how that would work. But right now, look at that, it's weeds. This right here is a dandelion. It's nothing but weeds. The grass is weedy looking. It just don't have that carpet look that I like. The grass seeds are on top of it, but the weeds are all in there. See, there's the dandelion. There's the dandelion. Okay, so I'm gonna cut the grass and show you what it looks like. You cut it. Okay, here's the grass when I cut it. You can still see the weeds in there. See there? And the grass seeds went back in the grass. I didn't put the mulch back in, so I put it in the bag, and you can see the dirt, which is what you want the seeds to go in. But it just doesn't have, there's too much weed in there. Look at that. Look at the weeds. Here's some dandelions. See, you're just really cutting over the dandelion. See, that's a dandelion. It's weeds. Look over here. See? It's, the grass is too weedy. Too much weed in it. Look at that. So I'm going to plant some premium grass seeds, which is a mixture, and then I want the blue, the Kentucky blue grass. I like that, it's thicker. I'm going to plant it right on top of this. But the first thing you want to do after the snow melts is put that crabgrass preventer down and some fertilizer to kill all of these weeds first. I recommend that early March. This is what, April, May now, so I put some down. And then I would plant my grass seeds. I have some oil in the yard that I spill, so that's the spot. I would plant grass seeds here to fill that up. And get the lawn that I want. Okay, and I will show you the next step. Okay, welcome back. This is my grass after I have planted my choice grasses, which in this case is Kentucky bluegrass because it's thick, and I'm going to show you what it looks like. I love that Kentucky bluegrass. Kentucky bluegrass is thick. See that? Then the other mixture of grass is in there. But you notice the weeds are not as bad. You're still going to have some, but you don't hardly see them. I had some extra dirt where I covered the oil leak. That's just dirt, but it's going to settle in the ground and the grass is going to cover, but that oil spot is gone. But that's the Kentucky bluegrass. Look how thick it is. See it? It's thick here, and the grass seeds are right there is what I want. When I cut the grass, it's going to reseed itself and put itself right back in the ground. You do not want to cut the grass low. I cut mine high so I can get the grass seeds. Let me show you. When you get those grass seeds, it will go back into the ground. See? So you're reseeding your alarm every time you cut. Look at that. Look at those grass seeds. You're saving money too. When you cut it low, the grass won't seeds won't grow so high. So when you cut it high, the grass seeds will come. And then you will cut it and it will go back to your yard. And it will look like this. Now this is a cut grass. Cut line.